Stand aside, la Nvidia, the world's very first living machine. Now you can create playlists for your pets. Hello, welcome back to MLM Monday Logins with Michelle, where I share with you all the latest tech news from last week. Oof. Lunar New Year to all my friends and kawan 朋友们. How was your holiday? If you haven't watched our most honest CNY video yet, please go and watch it later. It is on our Facebook page. Today's first story is on AMD's RS5600 XT. Priced at only 1.1k ringgit, it stands between the RS5500 and RX5700 series. Let's take a quick look at the comparison. The RS5600 XT even beats the more expensive Nvidia RTX 2060 at 1080p range with maximum settings, which means you no longer need to lower down your settings to achieve your desired FPS anymore. Powered by AMD RDNA architecture, it is made for selected esports and AAA games within the 1080p range. Literally an adrenaline boost to the system, it will help manifest stunning visuals, smooth and high performance experiences. Stand aside lah, Nvidia GTX 1660 Ti, wow. You cannot even match up despite being in a similar price range and segment market. For more info on the AMD RX 5600 XT, let's head on to our website. But if you don't know what is our website URL, you need me to whack you already. There is an affordable phone in the market with a crazy display refresh rate and a very, very fantastic camera. It is the Poco X2 by Poco Phone, a sub-brand by Xiaomi. It is making a comeback after launching its first ever Poco Phone F1 in 2018. There are rumors saying that the X2 is actually a rebranded version of Redmi's K30. And if that's the case, then we can expect an LCD screen and a side-mounted fingerprint scanner. It uses a Sony IMX686 sensor to achieve 64 megapixel camera resolution. It comes with a liquid cooling heat pipe, which is similar to its previous brother F1 and supports fast wired charging and comes with a 3.5mm headphone jack. X2 is said to have a 120Hz display, great for gamers, and it will be running on a Qualcomm processor, allowing it to have a smoother display than the OnePlus 70 or Google Pixel 4. Many rumors are pointing to the processor being a Snapdragon 765G, but could Poco actually surprise us with something more high-end? I don't know. You also don't know. We only know on February 4 when it launches. Scientists may have just created the world's very first living machine called the Xenobots, made from stem cells that came from the African cod frog. It does not look like frogs at all. It also doesn't look like the traditional robots we all know about. Instead, it looks like a pink blob that measures up to 1mm wide. That is so tiny! Well, these organisms, they can move independently or collectively and can survive up to weeks at a time. It can even heal itself because one of the scientists is sliced through the organism and it started healing itself and moving again. There are many things xenobots can do, including transporting medicine inside a patient's body, targeting toxic spills or radioactive contamination, collecting marine microplastics, or even removing plague in human arteries. In the future, they can even be incorporated into bioweapons. Researchers all say that these cute little blobs can achieve so much more compared to typical robots made out of steels and plastic. Cute things for the win! Cyberpunk 2077 is a highly anticipated new role-playing game from the studio behind the Witcher series. It was set to release on April 16, but now it has been pushed back to September 17. That is like 4 to 5 months later. Not sure what causes the delay, but a statement from the studio says that the game is complete and is playable. There's just more work to be done to make the game perfect, which includes playtesting, fixing and polishing. Postponing the launch will grant the studio more time to perfect the game and meet everyone's expectations. What a good PR! However, there's a rumor circulating saying that the game is very, very bad on the PS4 and the Xbox One. Maybe that is why it is delayed. I don't know. What do you think? Here's a fun one. Don't we all love Spotify because it can create playlists for us and also discover new songs for us based on what we like? Not only that, now you can create playlists for your pets. It will be based on what you like to listen to and also your pet's attribute. Here's how. First, you'll need to go to this website, pets.byspotify.com, and just follow the instructions. Let's go. Log in with Facebook. Continue. First, you'll need to pick a pet, such as a cat, a dog, iguana, bird, hamster. I guess they don't have things like snakes or fish because they don't have ears. I'm gonna pick dog because I'm making a playlist for our office dog, Buffy. Okay, tell us more about your dog. So I guess I'll be answering the questions with this sliding liver. Buffy is not really energetic. She's always sleeping and snoring in the office, so I'll put her slightly relaxed. Yeah. She's not shy, she's friendly, but not over friendly like crazy. So just put it right there. Lastly, apathetic or curious? Is it apathetic like depressed? That's not Buffy, she's... But she's not too curious too, I guess. So I'll just put it right there. Let's see that face. I'm gonna upload a picture of Buffy. Ah, cute Buffy. Done. And my pet's name is B-U-F-F-Y. FYI guys, Buffy is a female dog. Almost there. Come on, here's your playlist. Okay, now let's bring in Buffy, our MOBHouse baby, and see if she appreciates the music or not. Hi Buffy, welcome to the show MLM. Here is a playlist I created for you with Spotify Pets, okay? Now we listen to the first song, ah. Are you enjoying it? Buffy, what are you feeling from this song? What emotions are you getting, huh? Oh, I guess the music is giving you appetite, is it? Ah! If you have a pet at home also, go try this out. Tell me what is your pet's favorite song. That is all for today's MLM. This is Buffy and I'm Michelle. I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye! Say bye, Buffy. Woof! In the future, they can even be incorporated. Cyberpunk 2077. The highly anticipated Neural Gap.